Hey. Good afternoon. Welcome to Christ the Redeemer as we gather to celebrate the liturgy for the 32nd Sunday of Ordinary Time. We're making our way to the end of the liturgical year. There's only two more weekends after this. We'll get to the Feast of Christ the King, and then it'll be Advent, and then it'll be Christmas, then it'll be the end of the year. So welcome to the season called Hollow Thanksmas. Halloween, Thanksgiving, Christmas, and we're done. Is anybody here for the first time today? Anybody visiting, church shopping, church hopping? No? Just us. All right, take a moment to put your cell phone on vibrate or silent so it doesn't disturb our time together. And then let's stand and join in our gathering song. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always. Brothers and sisters, as we come together to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we call to mind two women who are prominent in today's first reading and today's gospel. Women who lived in poverty, yet gave all they had. Sometimes we, too, are asked to give from our resources, whatever they may be. And sometimes we are cheap, and sometimes we are stingy. And for those times when others need us to give, but we don't, let us seek mercy and forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Together we give praise and glory to God.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
With praise and with blessing, with
the Lord, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory.
Lord,
God Almighty, Father,
brothers and sisters, let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that, unhindered in mind and body, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. The prophet Elijah lived around 800 BC. This prophet stood up to King Ahab, who had introduced foreign gods to Israel. Elijah, fearing for his life, runs away from the king. All the people then experience a great drought. Today's first reading takes place in this context.
A reading from the first book of Kings. In those days, Elijah the prophet went to Zarephath. As he arrived at the entrance of the city, a widow was gathering sticks there. He called out to her, "Please bring me a small cupful of water to drink." She left to get it, and he called out after her, "Please bring along a bit of bread." She answered, "As the Lord your God lives, I have nothing baked. There is only a handful of flour in my jar and a little oil in my jug. Just now I was collecting a couple of sticks to go in and prepare something for myself and my son. When we have eaten it, we shall die." Elijah said to her, "Do not be afraid. Go and do as you propose. But first, make me a little cake and bring it to me. Then you can prepare something for yourself and your son. For the Lord, the God of Israel, says, 'The jar of flour shall not go empty, nor the jug of oil run dry until the day when the Lord sends rain upon the earth. She left and did as Elijah had said. She was able to eat for a year, and he and her son as well. The jar of flour did not go empty, nor the jug of oil run dry, as the Lord had foretold through Elijah. The word of the Lord.
A proclamation of Psalm 146.
On Yom Kippur, the Jewish Day of Atonement, the high priest sacrificed a goat on the altar in the temple. Then he took some of the blood into the holiest place of the temple sanctuary, where only he was allowed to go. There, he sprinkled that blood as a renewal of the covenant made at Mount Sinai, and prayed that God would forgive all the sins that the people have committed during the previous year. This ritual of Yom Kippur is the backdrop for today's second reading.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Christ did not enter into a sanctuary made by hands, a copy of the true one, but heaven itself, that he might now appear before God on our behalf. Not that he might offer himself repeatedly, as the high priest enters each year into the sanctuary with blood that is not his own. If that were so, he would have had to suffer repeatedly from the foundation of the world. But now, once for all, he has appeared at the end of the ages to take away sin by his sacrifice. Just as it is appointed that human beings die once, and after this the judgment, so also Christ, offered once to take away the sins of many, will appear a second time, not to take away sin, but to bring salvation to those who eagerly await him. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. In the course of his teaching, Jesus said to the crowds, "Beware of the scribes who like to go around in long robes and accept greetings in the marketplaces, seats of honor in synagogues, and places of honor at banquets. They devour the houses of widows, and as a pretext, recite lengthy prayers. They will receive a very severe condemnation." Then he sat down opposite the temple treasury and observed how the crowd put money into the treasury. Many rich people put in large sums. A poor widow also came and put in two small coins worth a few cents. Calling his disciples to himself, Jesus said to them, "Amen. I say to you, that poor widow put in more than all the other contributors to the treasury. For they have all contributed from their surplus wealth, but she, from her poverty, has contributed all she had, her whole livelihood." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Two widows, and as widows, without husbands, living a very simple life with very few resources. One of them, anticipating that she and her son will soon die from starvation. So little are her resources. Another, going to the temple treasury, and even with her little bit of money, makes a donation. Both of them become models for us. One makes a snack for the prophet Elijah. "Bring me a cup of water and a cake before you make some food for your own." The other gives her two coins. And in this way, they are models of what we call sacrificial giving. It's true what Jesus says. Most of us make our sacrificial giving, whether to the church or other charities, out of surplus money. After we've paid all our bills, after we've met all of our responsibilities and obligations, the money that's left over is what people tend to give to charity, whether that charity is the church or some other nonprofit organization, all of which are good causes. But the two women in today's readings urge us to consider real sacrificial giving, which is digging more deeply than simply giving our surplus. And surplus isn't just money. That's where our minds automatically go. We're talking about money. No, we're not talking about money. In today's first reading, the woman has a little bit of flour and a little bit of oil. And even though she has so little and is anticipating dying of starvation after her last meal with her son, still Elijah says, "Yeah, okay, but first make me something to eat." And she does. With her little bit of food, she makes a little for him. So sometimes our sacrificial giving is in things besides money. It might be time. It might be attention. It could be other resources like food from our own home. It could be lots of things. When we talk about sacrificial giving that comes from our resources, it means everything that we have available to us. The widow of Zarephath in today's first reading gave what she had because she could. And she did so with a generous heart. The woman in today's gospel gives her two coins to the temple treasury. On the surface, it's much less than other people were able to give. But as Jesus says, she gave all she had, her whole livelihood. But sometimes people brought food to the temple. Sometimes they brought crops or chickens or other things to be given to the poor. And so she too becomes a model of sacrificial giving, giving what she has. During the holiday season that is upon us, which began with Halloween, will continue with Thanksgiving, go through Christmas, and into the end of the year, all of us are going to be inundated with requests for generosity. Maybe you've already started getting stuff in the mail. Just today in the mail, I got something from my high school, reminding me of Giving Tuesday in November, that I can go online and make a gift or pledge to my Catholic high school from which I graduated last year. I have no doubt that my undergraduate, University of Detroit Mercy, will be reaching out with something similar in coming weeks. And even here at your parish, in the first week of December, we'll be having our annual St. Nicholas Project, asking people to sign up to do many different things. Those things require your time. We might ask you to adopt a family for Thanksgiving. That requires your money. You might take a tag off of the giving trees in the gathering area. That requires your money too. All of the things that are asking for our sacrificial giving are coming at us one upon another during this time of year. So it seems like today's readings are a good choice to help us do some examination of conscience in preparation for the requests for generosity that are upon us. Take a tag, take two, sign up for the St. Nicholas Project, adopt a family for Christmas or Thanksgiving, give to those other wonderful charities that are going to be reaching out in the next few weeks. But also, Think about the people who need your time. Think about the people who need your attention. Think about the ones who need your ear, the ones who need your love, the ones who need your understanding and compassion. Yes, in the broadest sense, the ones who are hungry for your mercy. Will you make them a little cake from your storehouse of resources? Will you give them a little something of your time and your attention? Will you give them just a bit of what you have and dig more deeply than just the surface, but even go in to the substance of what you possess? If we do, if we can, then we're responding to the example presented by these two widows in today's readings. And likewise, if we do, I am confident that we might enjoy the very same benefit that the widow of Zarephath enjoyed. She gave what little she had. She did so without counting the cost. She anticipated that she herself would die. But neither the oil nor the flour ran out. She found that in giving, she had more than enough. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us bring all of our cares and concerns before God's throne.
Christ died for the sake of sinners, the just one for the unjust. May the love of God flow through his holy church, extending to all of God's creatures. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Jesus offers us a peace the world cannot give. May we be open to his gift of peace, making it a reality throughout the earth. We remember veterans of military service and honor them for their sacrifice for the sake of peace. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
During a time of famine, God sent Elijah to a widow in a foreign land. May we carry the blessing of abundance to the world's hungry, to refugees and immigrants. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Jesus calls all governments to act with justice and equality. May our elected officials be men and women dedicated to working for the common good. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Jesus praised the poor widow's generosity. May her example inspire us to invest the substance of our lives in serving the gospel and those in need. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The Lord's heart is near to the broken ones and raises those bent low. We lift up all who are ill, especially those listed in the connection, as well as Bill Schramm, Mark Powell, Michael Robertson, Kevin Usista, Peter Plesch, and Kathy Donnelly. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
When Christ returns in glory, he will gather the just into the reign of God. May our beloved dead rejoice and sing with all the saints around God's heavenly throne. We remember those listed in our Book of the Dead and Sophie Roblevsky. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we grow in our reliance upon God's providence and confidently entrust all our needs to God who loves us. Especially these prayers for the family and friends of the Garski family: Joshua Santoro, Elizabeth Kuklika, and all the people of our parish. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Remember your love and your faithfulness, O Lord. Remember your people and have mercy on us, Lord.
Amen. Let us make our sacrificial offering.
The Lord is the Christ.
Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours might be made acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. Lord, look with favor on the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving kindness. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so love the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that we had lost through disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as with one voice we proclaim. Created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun till its setting, a perfect sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he took bread, gave thanks, blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when their supper was ended, he took a cup filled with wine, and once more, giving thanks and praise, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. When we eat this
therefore, Father, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection, and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you chose to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by his body and blood and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Joseph, her husband, with the apostles and martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. Lord, may this sacrifice of our reconciliation advance the peace and salvation of all the world. So be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, with the order of bishops and all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this earthly life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. For there we too hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now let us pray with confidence the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, protect us from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. Offer each other some sign of that peace. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, nourished by this sacred gift, we give you thanks and seek your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Holy Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in the people your heavenly power has entered. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. We have some announcements from Don. As Don gets to the microphone, just a reminder, tonight we fall back 1 hour, right? Daylight savings time ends. We go back to Eastern Standard Time. So fall back an hour before you go to bed, and you get an extra hour sleep. Ah. What else, Don?
There are a couple more announcements. We are in need of help in adopting families for Thanksgiving this year. Help us feed hungry families. Please see the table in the gathering area. We are excited to host a Christmas marketplace next weekend. Some great items will be available from several local nonprofits that have been unable to ensure their usual fundraising during the pandemic. Check out the full list in the connection. Take a tag or two
or five
from the Christmas giving tree as we care for the least of our sisters and brothers. Tags are also available online this year. Our second inquiry session for the Rite of Christian Initiation of Adults, RCIA, is Sunday after the 11 o'clock Mass. Contact Drew Peters for more information. His email can be found in the connection. And envelopes and information for Catholic Charities of Southeast Michigan can be found in this week's connection as well. Read the connection to learn more details of this year's St. Nicholas Project and where to donate your leftover Halloween candy for local children's organizations.
Amen. There is a table in the gathering area with sign-ups for different, five or six different events associated with the St. Nicholas Project, and that's going to be on December 2nd, 3rd, and 4th. So check your calendar, see if you're available. Sometimes it's driving, so you'll be making the offering of gas and time. Sometimes it's things to do here. So check out that table, too. What else,
great.
Don?
Finally, during the month of November, you are invited to inscribe the names of your loved ones who died this past year in the Book of the Dead, which is located in front of the Eucharistic Chapel.
Amen. May the Lord be with you. May the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord and show mercy to your neighbor.